It took me 2 hours to leave Tbilisi. Then I'm on the highway again. Not far from Tbilisi, George Assoli's place. At the confluence of Kura and Araqui, Misrata is located. Georgia's capital for 1,000 years. Here began the Christianization of Georgia. Destination of the day was Gori. I had booked a room at Guesthouse Emma, but Emma had already left. Friendly relatives opened the door for me and took care of the breakfast. I was the only guest in the big house. Stalin was born in Gori, and his museum is still very popular with guests from home and abroad. The town hall of Gori. It was built by German prisoners of World War II and is also called Reichstag because of its dome. Its name Gori has from the fortress Gorizieche from the 17th century, which is preserved until today. The town is only 25 kilometers away from South Ossetia, but the area has not been accessible from Georgia since the Wars of Independence in 2008. From time to time you can see cars of the EUMM, the European Monitoring Mission, which tries to keep the peace here. Before I continue, I had a look at the cave town Ablizieche from the 6th century before Christ. Then I continued to Kutaisi. Partly over the highway with its impressive new rest stops. Also, these are causing some discussions in Georgia. They are internationally rated as quite successful architecturally. The highway is not quite finished yet, and so the cars move on country roads through small towns and green hilly countryside. The entrance to Kutaisi was unfortunately not designed to the size of a Land Cruiser. But also smaller cars had problems. But with a little bit of cranky, it finally worked, and sometime I stood in front of the hotel. In the morning, still fried egg with tomato and cucumber, also certainly well mint. I couldn't see it anymore at some point. The Bagrati Cathedral, high above the city on a hill. By the way, the Georgian language has its own script with 33 letters, which developed in the 5th century under Greek influence from Aramaic. A small cable car in Kutaisi over the Rioni River to a hill. And the market hall. Near Kutaisi are the monasteries Gelati and Mozameta, as well as the Okatse Canyon. I went there with two German girls from Leipzig who had a hiking holiday in Georgia. On a footbridge, you can walk in the canyon up to a viewing platform. Now it was not far anymore to Batumi at the Black Sea. There is still an old town in Batumi, but actually everything there is designed for tourism. New hotels are rising everywhere. The beach promenade was extended from 800 meters to 5 kilometers, and there is even more space at the end.
Roundabout.
15 kilometers away from Batumi in the direction of the Turkish border, there is a 2,000-year-old Roman fort near Gonyo. A quiet oasis away from the hustle and bustle. The Georgians will already know why good luck stands in the direction of the Turkish border. Anyway, I didn't have one. The Turkish entry stamp already pressed in my passport was marked as invalid. Reason: my German passport and the Australian car registration were inadmissible. Both registration must allegedly be from one country. Despite of unpleasant discussions with the head of the Turkish control authority, I had no choice but to turn back. Turkey was the only country on the whole trip that made it impossible for me to continue. Back in Batumi, I first looked for a cheap hotel and then I bought a ferry ticket across the Black Sea to Burgas in Bulgaria. It was not easy to find the ferry office, but the language hurdles were not quite as high as in Aktau in Kazakhstan. After a few days, the ferry started. Bye Georgia, bye Caucasus, let's go to Europe. Also the Druzhba on the Black Sea had a delay because of a storm, like already the Mercury 1 on the Caspian Sea. But as a traveling truck driver said to me, if the Black Sea becomes wide, then the ships should stay in the port.